recording inside of Parklea Correctional Center. This place is a dead set joke. Okay, it's a dead set joke. Why am I carrying around a knife like that? Why does that need in my hand at this point in time? Why have I got a slasher? Why do I need to slash people? That's just an example of what it can do to your throat. All right, now see all that? That's the drug ice. Why have I got it? Because I can.
This video, filmed on a smartphone, was uploaded to YouTube. And for me, it raises so many questions. Where did he get the phone, the drugs, and the weapons? Why did he film it in the first place? And what else is going on behind these walls that we don't know about?
Now this jail is ruining lives. It is killing the young people, the young generation of this place.
The sprawling suburbs of Western Sydney. Two-storey brick homes, leafy green spaces, and in the middle of it, a maximum security prison. From the outside, it's pretty imposing. High fences, razor wire, and security cameras. But that's about as much as I can see. Beyond the front gate is off limits. We applied for permission to film inside, but the Department of Justice said no.
Chaotic. My belief the whole time I was there was at some stage, if something doesn't change, someone will get killed there.
Denied access myself, I've come to meet Louis Wickets. He's a former Parklea inmate who wrote to the feed a few months ago with deep concerns about the prison.
That could seriously injure someone.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. I guess when you've got all this with the blades and whatnot, and the mobile phones, and then you throw ice into it, it's going to step everything up another level with violence and just the chaos of it. A lot of guys on a lack of sleep over long periods of time. Yeah, recipe for disaster.
Louis spent 15 years going in and out of jails for drugs and drug-related crimes, and he says Parklea is the worst by far.
Violence, fights, plenty of drug use, bupe, methadone, ice, syringes, needles, mobile phones, used mobile phones in there myself. And most of the time when I was using a phone, it was always about organising money to do with drugs or drugs to do with visits.
Louis says he left Parklea worse off than when he went in, and that the side of prison that's meant to rehabilitate people is just not working there.
The drug use, the trauma, the escalation in violence, the escalation in drug use, they come out damaged.
If you look at the stats, Parklea has a higher rate of inmates assaulting each other than other similar prisons. Louis thinks staffing is partly to blame.
Definitely not enough staff to deal with situations, but also majority of staff there, noticeably not enough experience to be working in there. A lot of them you could just see at different times that they were out of their depth. Lower staff numbers creates more space for stuff to happen.
Inmates at Parklea are also more likely to die of unnatural causes. Since 2016, there have been 7 suicides inside Parklea.
There's never another picture with my brother. He's not going to see his son turn 18. He's not going to be able to teach him to drive. It's torn our world apart.
Wendy Johnson's brother, who she's asked us not to name, was sent to Parklea on remand, waiting for his day in court. That wait can be many, many months.
Probably about 3 to 4 months in, you could start to tell how much it was wearing on him.
Wendy's brother, let's call him Joe, was not the kind of guy to shy away from asking for help. He'd been put on antidepressants before he went into Parklea, and once inside, he had a number of appointments with a mental health nurse and psychiatrist. But about 6 months in, Joe's mental state deteriorated.
He was starting to say, you know, I don't know how much longer I can keep going. I need to talk to somebody. I need to get some medication adjustments done.
Joe had an episode where he self-harmed. But it's what happened or didn't happen next that worries his family.
So he missed an appointment. Tell me about that.
Yeah, so he was in the clinic for self-harming. They did schedule an appointment for him. He missed that appointment. He missed it. Nobody came and got him for that appointment, and there was no follow-up and no recurring appointment set after that. He can't just mosey on up to that clinic. He has to be taken to the clinic. Around about a month after that, he took his own life.
The case is still before the coroner, and Wendy and her family want answers.
He should be here. He really, really should be here. If he'd have gotten help, there's no doubt in my mind he'd be here today.
It's very important that people get followed up. Prison's a very isolating environment. If you are giving mental health interventions, you want to ensure that they're working.
Dr. Andrew Ellis is a forensic psychiatrist. He's visited and assessed inmates at Parklea Prison on and off for about 18 years. And he says there was a point about 9 years ago where it became much harder for him to do his work there.
There was a noticeable difference when the private provider took over the running of the operation. Staff were much less efficient at getting you in to see people. Professional visitors like myself seemed to be more of an inconvenience.
In 2009, Parklea went from a government-run prison to a privately-run prison. A big US company called Geo took over. The contraband, the high levels of violence and drugs all took place under Geo's watch. Perhaps the lowest point for Parklea under Geo was last year when the New South Wales government staged an intervention and took over operations for 5 weeks. They raided the jail looking for contraband. The general manager was eventually removed. Now, current and former correctional officers have spoken out at a parliamentary inquiry into the prison.
It's a joke. It's so dangerous. Like, you can go into a wing with 80 inmates on your own, but they'll say one person has to stay in the office.
I escorted 17 inmates from reception by myself. The official policy is that you're to have at least two officers, usually between 4 and 6 crims. But because there's no one else and you want to help out, it had to be done.
If officers go sick or are needed to go to hospital escort, they're routinely not replaced, which has left us with as little as 3 officers for almost 1,000 inmates.
We had a string of issues that happened in a very short period of time that were reported and we stepped in.
The man who oversaw the intervention at Parklea is the State's Commissioner for Corrective Services, Peter Severin.
Prisoners and prisons are difficult and at times very dangerous places. And things happen because prisoners have a very clear focus on testing the system, trying everything they possibly can.
The Commissioner says the government is committed to having a mix of private and public prisons.
For me, it's not about costs. For me, it's actually about indirect competition. It's about learning from each other.
Despite all the problems at Parklea, the government is committed to keeping it in private hands. The prison's contract is due to expire in April next year. The new management is a joint venture between US prisons company, MTC, and a Spanish-owned group called Broad Spectrum. This is an MTC-run prison in the US. I meet up again with Louis to see what he makes of this.
They had these riots that went on for several days.
It's insane.
In 2015, there were riots at 2 of their prisons, one in Arizona and another in Texas. In both cases, MTC lost the contracts. The New York Times also recently published a video showing an inmate being beaten at an MTC-run prison and guards failing to intervene.
So 30 minutes after that assault, the guards come in. What do you think of that?
It's a worry is what I think of it. It's a worry to think that this is the company that's going to come in and take over GEO, a prison that's already got dramas, and then they can't already look after their own facilities in America, so it doesn't inspire confidence.
So MTC is very much known in the United States as a provider that focuses very strongly on good offender management. So yes, they have had some difficulties 10, 12 years ago in some of their operations, but it is putting it into context. We are comfortable with the operator that we have chosen.
When we think about private prisons, it's usually the US that comes to mind.
But in Australia, over 18% of our prisoners are in privately run facilities. That's twice as many as in the States. And all the incidents that have happened at Parklea have made people wonder if that's a good thing.
Is it good to privatise our jails? You know, and if it is a good thing, then we need to see the evidence.
Jane Andrew and Max Baker have crunched the numbers around private prisons in Australia. They've looked over GEO's contract with Parklea.
So there's a list of costs, but all of those costs have been redacted.
We know that prisons like Parklea are making a profit out of locking people up. But we just can't see exactly how they do that.
So we don't know how much is being spent on labour. We don't know how much is being spent on other things that are important to the jail.
We've had 17 years of prisons, private prisons in New South Wales, and we still, even after all that time, don't have enough information to make a judgment call.
This place is a dead set joke. It's a dead set joke. Why am I carrying around a knife? Why have I got a slasher? All right, now see all that? That's the drug ice.
Australia's prison population has increased by more than a third in the last 5 years. Tonight, around 43,000 people are locked up behind bars, and nearly 8,000 of them are in private prisons. But why should we care about who runs our prisons or what happens inside?
My brother was abiding by the system. He was arrested. He was on remand, awaiting a bail hearing, but he was a person.
You know, I guess I'd say, well, what happens in the prisons affects the community, because eventually guys have to get out of jail.
These days, Louis Ricketts is clean. He's studying social work and building the future he wishes he'd started 15 years ago.
Seeing young guys in there now, you know, there needs to be change, needs to be created, because it's not working. It's obvious it's not working. Something needs to change.